Good days, guys. In the past few days, we are discussing some of the properties included in cascading style sheets. To refresh all of us, all of you, my students, this is the following properties that I discussed to you last video tutorial. First is the typography. Second is box model. Yung fundamental concept describes layout and sizing elements of web page that contain that have of components or may components of content, padding, border, and margins. So this is the different properties include under the box models. Then I discussed already to all of you is layout, na kung saan it refers to how elements are arranged and positions on a web page. CSS provides various techniques for creating different layouts, allowing designers to control the visual structure and organization of content within a web page. So, under the layout, we have a properties of display, position, top, right, bottom, left, float, clear. We also discussed in the past lecture is a backgrounds and borders, which is needed in our creating designs in web. So mahalagang parte ng website natin yung paggamit ng backgrounds natin at saka ng borders natin. So we are here to discuss different properties of backgrounds and borders, which is background color, background image, background repeat, background position, border colors, border styles, and border width. So some of them are needed and very important in every designs that we are creating in using cascading style sheet. So here are the examples for this. Next is effects. Refer to visual enhancements and animations applied to elements on a web. So we all know that effects will help us to make it sure that our output will be effective and efficient for the viewers and audience of our website. So it will be more entertainable para sa kanila and to get the attention of them to open and watch, open and view our websites. So the effects under the cascading style sheets that we can add is the opacity, back shadow, text, shadows, and transitions. This is the following syntax that we can include here. Next is Flexbox. It is a layout model in CSS that provides a more efficient way to arrange and align elements within a container. It allows you to create complex layouts with ease, making it particularly useful for building responsive and dynamic web design. So we also create web designs to make it sure responsive and flex than to the older websites that we encounter. Using that Flexbox, we can create a dynamic websites or responsive and dynamic web designs that suit to the needs and want of the viewers and audience that we have. So ngayon, yung mga Flexbox na yan is very important to us. So we have different kinds of properties under the Flexbox, which is Flex Directions, Flex Wrap, Flex Flow, Justify Content, Align Items, Align Content Order, Flex Grow, Flex Strings, and Flex Basis. This is the following tags or syntax that we can add using the Flexbox. Flex Wrap, okay. Then followed by grid layout, which is commonly referred to as grid. It is a powerful layout system in cascading style sheet that provides a way to create complex and responsive web layouts. It allows designers and developers to arrange elements into two-dimensional grid where you can define both rows and columns. In grid layout, it is very important when it comes in knowing the rows and columns that we adding to your website. So when it comes in responsiveness, it's very important. It provides two-dimensional grid for the output. So this is the following properties under the grid layout: the grid template columns, grid template rows, grid gap, grid grow gap, grid column gap, grid template areas, grid grid auto columns, auto rows, auto flows, column row self, and align self. Then, and followed by animation. So, ano ba yung animation? This is the next topics that I need to discuss after I discuss some of the properties that I discussed already. So, this time, I will discuss to you the animations and the importance of that animations. So, first, what is animations? It's allow you to animate the properties of HTML elements without using JavaScript. With CSS animations, you can create engaging and interactive effects to enhance user experience. So we all know that animations nowadays is very important when it comes in creating websites because of the attentions because of the designs and animations that can provide to our viewers and audience, yung entertainment that can create you engaging and interactive effects na makakatulong to get the attentions of our viewers and audience. So, mas na-enhance natin yung mga experience user, yung user experience nila. Yung user experience, it is because of what they can see in your website, kung ano yung makikita nila, kung ano yung pwede nilang ma-explore sa websites mo. Sabi nila, CSS animation is widely supported in modern browsers, but it's essential to check compatibility if you need to support older version. Also, prefixing might be needed for some properties to ensure compatibility. Nowadays, kakaunti na yung sumusupport when it comes in older way of how to create websites. So, more on tinitingnan na natin ngayon, part na ng design natin ngayon, yung tinatawag natin na animations because it gives entertainment. It gives more efficient, it gives more effective designs kapag merong animation yung isang design natin or isang web design natin. So, mahalagang bahagi ng website natin na ngayon yung tinatawag na natin na animations. But, we need to know ano-ano ba yung mga pwede natin i-include when it comes in animations and it will not easy to us. It will not be hindi siya magiging ganun kadali when it comes in creating animations because nakita natin na simple lang naman yung website. We don't need add any entertainment part. But nowadays, sa mga bagong generations ngayon, we are checking how the website entertain our audience. How the website get their attentions to open it, to read it, to know the content of your website para makita lang nila ano ba yung kayang i-provide ng isang website or ng website na gusto nilang buksan. So that different animations that can give engaging, interactive not only for the effects but also interactive to those audience and viewers that we have. Ano-ano ba yung mga ano-ano yung mga properties included when it comes in animations? We have animation name, animation durations, animation timing functions, animation delay, animation interaction count, animation directions, animation film mode, animation play state. Kung mapapansin nyo sa mga properties na to, we are including some of the animations which is you already do that, na ginagawa na natin, but typically not in a code. We are using this kapag nagawa tayo ng mga video presentations na kung saan binibigyan natin or nilalagyan natin ng mga animations. So, through that, nakikita natin o paglalagay ng timing, kung paano natin i-delay yung mga video, yung mga part na yan, pwede natin yung gawin actually when it comes in editing a video. But this times, we are using all of that properties in syntax using the cascading style sheet. So, this is the passive, this is some of the syntax that we need to know when it comes in creating animation. First is the keyframes. So, ano ba yung ginagamit natin keyframes? Yung keyframes po natin, we are using it for slide in. So, paano natin siya ginagawa? Kung makikita po natin dito, we have the transform translate X. Then, we have the transform translate X. So, katayo po maglalagay ng value dito. So, -100%, depende sa kung ano yung pangangailangan ng slide-in na gagamitin natin. Then, we have the apply the animation. So, we have the animation slide-in, first, second, ease out. So, pwede po nating ilagay ito. Depende kung paano nyo siya gagamitin. So, all of that is part of the animations. And you can use some of the properties that I discussed to you last slide. So, like yung animation name, durations, delay. So, all of that is needed. So, ito po yung sample na pwede natin paggayahan. So, keyframe slide in 0%, 100%. Then elements with 100 EX height, background color blue, animation slide in 1 seconds is out. Followed by transform. This is the last topic that I need to discuss in cascading style sheet and the others. So transformations are powerful tools for creating visual appealing effects and animations in cascading style sheet. They are widely supported in modern browsers and are commonly used in conjunctions with other cascading style sheet features like transitions and animations. So all of that is required. All of that is needed. When it comes to that, gumagawa tayo ng transform para makagawa tayo ng mga 2D, 3D na mga effects or designs when it comes in our website. So, ano ba yung tinatawag natin o ano-ano ba yung we need to consider when it comes in transform? We need to consider the transform origin, others, cursor, size, index, outline, and overflow. So, ano-ano ba yung mga kailangan i-discuss? Ano-ano yung mga included when it comes in transform? So, sa transform po kasi, we have we need to know the use of x-axis, the y-axis, and the z-axis. So, it is very important to know the differences of the x, y, and z-axis. So, ano-ano po ba yun? So, first, we need to know ano ba yung tinatawag natin na transform. When it comes in typically transform or the basic simple transform, it provides x-axis and y-axis. So, kapag sinabi po natin na x and y-axis, kapag po sinabi natin x, it is horizontally. Kapag sinabi naman po natin na y, it is vertically. And then, kapag sinabi naman po natin z-axis, ito yung pag-ikot or yung paggagawa kung paano natin gagawin sa 3D, yung pag hindi siya technically rotate yung paning niya, yung paano siya gagalaw. So iyon po yung tinatawag natin na z-axis. So sa transform origin, we have the x axis, y axis, and z axis. So kailangan alam din po natin kung paano na kung alin yung lalagyan natin ng sapat na value when it comes in x, y, and z axis. Then next is the example, translate 3D XYZ. So honestly, when it comes in transform, we have a lot to know when it comes in transform. So sa transform po kasi, we have a common transform functions. We have the translate. Sa translate po, meron tayong X and Y moves the elements from its current positions. When it comes in translate X, it moves element horizontally by X. So, kapag naman sinabi natin, translate y, it moves the element vertically. So, differ, makikita natin yung pagkakaiba. Kapag x, horizontally siya nag-moves, while the translate, it moves vertically. Then, meron din tayong tinatawag dito na scale x, y. Scale the element by x horizontally and y vertically. So, ito yung pag-scale natin. So, titingnan natin diyan yung doubles the width and increasing height by 1.5 times. So, syempre, kailangan natin din ma-define natin kung alin ba kung ano yung i-scale natin at ano yung lalagyan natin na value sa scale natin. Then, another one, we need to consider the rotate or the angles or rotates the elements by the specified angle. So, as a developer, as a programmer, you are the responsible to define kung anong angle yung kailangan niya mag-rotate at kung anong degree yung rotation niya. So, rotates the elements 45 degrees clockwise. So, iyon po yung mga ginagamit natin. So, depende sa inyo kung anong degree nyo siya gagamitin at kung anong degree ang ilalagay nating value when it comes in the rotate. When it's next is the skew or x angle and y angle, squeeze the elements of the specified angle. So squeeze the elements along the x axis and squeeze the element along the y axis. So tandaan nyo po, kapag sinabi po natin squeeze, ang ginagamit lang po natin ay x axis at saka y axis. Wala pong z axis po tayo dito. Matrix. We have the A, B, C, D, E, F. Defines a 2D transformation using the matrix of the six values. Okay. So, itong matrix A, B, C, D, E, F na to, tayo din po maglalagay. It combines, translate, scale, skew, and rotate. So, yan po yung pwede natin gamitin. So, ito po ay combines na po siya ng mga translate, scale, skew, and yung tinatawag natin na rotate. Other one is transform functions in 3D. So, paano naman kapag 3D yung ginagamit natin? That is the times that we need to use the z-axis or moves the elements in 3D space. So, kapag yung z po na tinatawag natin, it moves the elements in 3D space. So, ano ba yung tinatawag natin na translate z? Moves the element along the z-axis. So, that transforms translate 3D, kung mapapansin nyo dun sa una, we are using the x and y axis. But this time, when it comes in using your 3D, we are using z axis. It moves elements in 3D space. So, para natin magawa yung tinatawag natin na 3D. So, it moves like in 3D space natin na tinatawag natin. So, we have scale 3D. So, we are using the x, y, z again. So, it scales the elements along the z-axis. It's the same when it comes to the first discussions, which is transform, na merong x and y. Gumamit din tayo ng scale doon, but technically, ang ginamit natin scale doon is x and y only. For this time, nadagdagan lang tayo ng z-axis, which is scales element in 3D space. So, para may scale naman natin yung element natin or yung ginagawa natin 3D or animation 3D into 3D space. Followed by rotate 3D, X, Y, Z angle naman po. So, same lang din po ng paggamit ng rotate natin sa kabila. Ang pinagkaiba lang niya, paano mag-rotate yung elements natin into Z axis. So, we are using rotate Z axis. So, depende kung anong degree ang ilalagay natin. So, tayo pa rin po yung maglalagay ng degree, tayo pa rin po ang maglalagay ng value ng x, y, z natin. So, almost same lang din po lahat. Ang pinagkaiba lang niya, nagkaroon na siya ng z axis for the 3D. Ano po? Next is combining multiple transformations. So, we have transform, translate, 5px, 100px, scale, 1.5, rotate, 30 degree. So, sa combining ko multiple transformations naman po, we are using in one tag, one properties, then the value po niya. Sa limbawa, translate. Ano po ba pag sinabi nating translate? We are adding x and y. So, sa x and y po, we can add the value of x and the value of y. Then, after ng translate, value natin siya, di ba, nasa loob po siya ng parenthesis, yung value ng x and y. Then, type lang po natin sunod yung scale, no, tapos yung value niya, kung 1.5 ba siya, 2 ba siya, 3 ba siya. So, lalagyan din natin scale inside the parenthesis. And last is rotate. Yung rotate po, how many degrees yung ilalagay natin para sa rotation ng 3D natin. So, that is called combining multiple transform. Ibig sabihin, sa transform na properties, we can add 3 value, which is yung value ng translate natin, value ng scales natin, and value ng rotate natin. So, that is combining ng 3, combining ng different transformation or yung tinatawag na combining multiple transformations when it comes in creating 3D. And next, we have a sample here. We have a sample here in our PowerPoint presentations, which is giving us an idea on how to create animation. So here, gumamit tayo dito ng width, height, then gumamit tayo ng background color, light blue. Then transform, magta-translate siya. Gumamit po tayo dito ng combining na combining multiple transforms. So we have the transform, ito po yung sinasabi ko sa inyo, this, pinagsama niya po yung translate, x and y, then rotate, yung value ng rotate nyo, which is in degree form. Then we have the scales. So after the discuss, we have the transitions, transform. Ano po ba ang magiging transitions ng ating animations na ginawa natin? Then we can add also hover, transform, translate. So, ibig sabihin, okay sir, sa hover po ba, pwede rin po ba tayo maglagay ng transform? Yes! Depende sa inyo kung saan natin ilalagay yung animations natin. So, this time, we have a hover which is indicated translate 50px, x and y, rotate 45 degree again, then scale 1.5. So, iyan po yung animations that I need to discuss in this meeting. This is the last topic that I need to discuss. That's all. Thank you.